So in triangle, ABC is an equilateral triangle. So as we have discussed in the earlier video also, whenever they give you some specific triangle or shape, any parallelogram or something like that, you need to have that understanding that those information are given. So in an equilateral triangle, all angles are equal to 60 degrees. That means in triangle ABC, we can interpret like this, that angle A is equal to angle B is equal to angle C equals to 60 degrees. Secondly, all sides are also equal. So we can say AB equals to BC equals to CA. So no need to write everything, but to have this understanding that these things are given already. Second thing is given, PQ is parallel to AC. PQ is parallel to AC. And in the figure, it was extended. So make sure PQ is parallel to AC is okay, but PQ is also parallel to AR, or you can say CR. This understanding you must have. Next is CR equals to BP. CR is equals to BP. This thing is given. So we need to prove that QR bisects PC. QR bisects PC. So QR bisects PC. So there are two ways of writing. QR and PC bisect each other, and here it is written QR bisects PC. That means only QR is bisecting PC. So we need to prove that PM equals to MC. PM, or you can say MP, equals to MC. Because while we write something, we need to interpret that thing into mathematical terms like equals to or some other form, like 60 degree if they are saying equilateral triangle. So we need to interpret that thing into that angles are 60 degree, because you cannot use this statement while proving the question. So let's focus. We need to prove that this should be equal to this, and it's very obvious that we need to prove that these two triangles are congruent. Since they are giving this side is equal to this side, as an examiner or whosoever forms the question does not give unnecessary information in the question just to distract, because in school level they do not give such kind of information just to distract. Every information is meaningful for the question. So make sure you focus on that information as well. Since CR is also equals to BP, so there must be some meaning, because this information will lead to this triangle. So let's see how. As this line is parallel, so we need to go back to our parallel line properties. So there are a few properties like alternate interior or corresponding or co-interior. So out of these three, one will be used here. Let's see how. And these two lines are parallel, and this angle is 60 degree. This angle is 60 degree. So this is interior of the parallel line, like this. So this angle can also be 60 degree because of this. One interior, one exterior by corresponding angle property. This is 60. So corresponding angle property we can use to prove that this angle is 60. And we already know that this angle is 60. So by angle sum property, this angle is also 60. Since all the three triangles in triangle QBP, all the angles are 60 degree. So this is also an equilateral triangle. So let's prove this first. As AC is parallel to PQ and BC is the transversal, therefore triangle ACP is equal to angle QPB by corresponding angles property, and angle B is equal to 60 degree. Already we can write 60 degree over here, therefore angle Q is also 60 degree by angle sum property. As we know, all the three angle sum is 180 degree, 60 plus 60, 120, 180 minus 120 is, again this angle is 60. Therefore, triangle QBB is an equilateral triangle. If a triangle is equilateral, its all sides are also equal. Therefore, BP equals to QP. All sides are equal. Since now we know this side is also equal to this, now we can move on to the congruency part. In triangle QPM is, and triangle RMC, let me draw the figure for you once again. This is P. PQM and RCM. This figure is like this. Sorry. PQM and RCM. So as we know, this side is already equal to this. So we have already discussed this, whenever there is a intersecting lines, alternate interior angles are always equal. So this angle is equal to this angle, and this line is parallel to this. So this angle is equal to this angle by alternate interior angle property. So we can prove this. Therefore, QP equals to CR, proved above. Angle 1 equals to angle 2,